A lot of myself tied up in these four walls. I've seen a lot of them over the past 2 years. I have been the manager here for close to a year and a half. And Homeground was formed really late 2017, looked for an open sort of Jan 2018. When we first opened, we were just a small cafe of people who had varying levels of experience in a cafe, who were also just trying to do something about the youth unemployment issue. Homeground really was put in this specific community to create a safe place in the environment where people can sit, be accepted, be involved in some way that is not just a service but a place that is beautiful and that is welcoming. The other one is our training cafe, so to be able to provide on-the-job training to help get young people hospitality experience so that we can start combating youth unemployment. And the third is sort of a bit of an overarching idea in terms of in both of those categories, being a nutritional or a healthy way approach towards food. We're categorised as a social enterprise and a not-for-profit. So anything that falls into the profit margin, that is then goes back into the community. I had a beautiful quote: "Every young person needs an irrational fan." Specifically talking about an adult irrational fan, and not the idea that what they tell them to do is irrational, but that person in their life that is like, "Come on, you can do it. You've got this, I'm behind you, that dream seems lofty, I believe in you." I think to have that level of encouragement and belief, I think, is just vital. But the amount of people that have come in and done training, and at some point we've had to have a conversation about, you are here as a trainee, and that's okay, you're not expected to be perfect right now. Like I expect you to come in and screw that coffee up. So that then I can say, oh, that's fine, that's not the end of the world, we're okay, this is how we grow. I'm not remotely expecting you to come in and nail this first shot. Because if you were doing that, then I'd probably say, you should go get a job somewhere. People come in to learn and then all of a sudden have a breakdown of the fact that they have to learn. And you sort of think, no, you're young, this is the process of learning, this is the not being good at something doesn't mean that you aren't going to be, and the process is hard and it's gross, and you're going to feel uncomfortable at times and you're going to learn to grow, but that's held properly, that's really beautiful. And that really bleeds into the mental health and the emotional state of learning how to cope in a work environment is the bulk of the stuff here, you know, and just being able to show up and be part of it. So for every one of my trainees, I mean, we could easily have a checklist of like, you need to make one latte, one sandwich, one this, and then you're done, your training's done. And if I had done that with all the young people that have come through these doors, I would have missed entirely what was going on. Sometimes you can't even fix it. It's not about the fact that they can't make a sandwich, it's like being around sharp objects and hot things freaks them the hell out. And so what our process then is, you know, okay, well, We're not going to talk about sandwiches, we're just going to do really basic things around some of like what it means to be safe, what it means to be this, and then slowly progress to the point where you feel comfortable in the kitchen. Or if not, we're going to just sit up in the front and we're going to make coffees, that kind of thing. You know, just because you're struggling in this area doesn't make you incompetent, and that also doesn't mean this isn't part of you, this is just a mix of coping mechanism and just trying to get through the day.
There's very little
that can't be at least infinitely improved by sitting down and learning someone's story and knowing their, and being willing to be there. And that is the most precious commodity of all, because it is time, but it is also, you have to be emotionally available to be there for someone else.
I remember being in year 12, I had become the class clown, and I felt stupid, so I acted dumb. I knew I could do trivia well, and I knew I could, like, I was eloquent, and I knew I was creative, but I thought I was really stupid. Like, I really didn't have much of a sense of cohesion in terms of my ability to, like, pull what was going on through my brain and onto paper. I was so in need of something that wasn't academic. Schools have now become the place to learn everything. Instead of being pigeonholed into one level of intelligence and now being able to flourish in these specific, incredible, weird, lovely moments and just career paths and just these niche things. What we've done in the schooling system is we've really created this bubble where the school now has to be a psychologist, like a teacher has to be a psychologist, also has to be a kind of a parent in some roles, and has to be an educator. You have to look at the fact that we have one teacher for 30 kids every, you know, and is that an effective way to gauge what every young person is doing? Teachers are trying to, I know teachers, you know, there's so many that are just working their asses off. And I see the frustration of what they are going through, because they're also in that rock and hard place of, like, you know, their job and what they're trying to get people to a competency level of is a certain degree to, so that there's, you know, employability. Then coming back full circle and realizing that I love learning. Like, I just want to learn every, you know, I want 100 lifetimes to learn every language, every, you know, however, to whatever degree of good I am at it, just the enjoyment of learning something new.
The most beautiful thing about a social enterprise and a not-for-profit is that my name's not on the door, and someone going in and giving a lot does not end up in my pocket. The people that come in because they love it and they have something to give have changed the whole game here. Without a shadow of a doubt, they're the people that have done some of the most beautiful work here. It's just, there's a really present sense of otherness.
Honestly, and without a doubt, it's the community that are here and the people who we've been able to sow into their life, but then retrospectively that they've sowed into ours. And there is something really quite beautiful happening that was always welcome, but you can't force it, you know, is having a beautiful community, you know, of just customers. There's this really kind of beautiful, cyclical, giving nature about the cafe.
Sometimes there's a bit of a cognitive dissonance between us. Like, one of the greatest mistreatments of the social media empire is that you can create your own echo chamber within seconds and you can hear from no one else outside of your perspective. And it's really bizarre because we're in a world where our biggest like keywords and buzzwords are about connection and you know, caring for the other. But it's becoming exceedingly rare to sit at a table, a generous table, where you don't necessarily hold the same beliefs as someone. So there's, like, you know, there's opinion, but then there's behavior, and then, you know, you can disagree with me, but as soon as that translates into I'm going to mistreat you because you, but then you have a line, whereas opposed to if I'm just not going to listen to you because you think differently to me, then anything that is slightly out of my own wheelhouse is danger. And people are assuming that they're not tribal anymore, but we're coming just as much tribal because it's still a base human reaction to fear. Every day we get closer to our goal of, you know, making the very best we can out of what we have.
I would be so excited to see where this place ends up in 5 years, how long the trajectory that we're going. I mean, we, you know, the standard that we're getting our coffee up to and our food up to, but then to then flesh out the training side of this and the scope of where we can go. I mean, to be able to then go do more offsite and event catering, and you know, to have our trainees go and be in some of the biggest cafes, biggest restaurants. Now we want to connect with as many people as humanly possible, business or individual alike. It's not about flying solo.
And I think to come meet us will probably be the main one. Come in, have a coffee, see what we're doing, see if you resonate with it and join in. If somewhere like this is a place to do it, all the merrier.